Hey guys, it's Danny. Alrighty, today, another spotlight video. This is the beautiful Kirchara. I forgot the name. Kirchara Jayrock Kiss Spot Lip. There you go, that's why I forgot the name. It's really complicated. So, I think you've already known this work. It's starting to create a flower spike for 4 or 5 or 6 months already. It has taken forever for these flowers to fully develop and bloom, but luckily, the wait is over. So, Kirchara. Does it ring any bell? What could this orchid be? Is it a species? No, it's actually a very complex hybrid. It is a Calea type hybrid, but it is complex in the sense of the genuses that were used in creating it. I'll just add them down below in the description because there's quite a lot of them. So you might say, oh, what a pretty Brassavola hybrid. Well, guess what? She's not a Brassavola hybrid, anything else but Brassavola. However, as you can see shape-wise, it does really remind of Brassavolas. And not only the flowers, but the actual orchid herself as well. The pseudobulbs are smaller than the leaves in comparison. They're not very plump and fat, while the leaf is pretty thin and pretty long. The flower spike arises from the top, pretty typical for Calea type orchids, but the flowers, they're really, really pretty. So I'll get you in closer, we'll take a better look at them, and we'll talk a little bit more. Now, the size of the flowers is not very impressive. I would say they have about 5 centimeters in diameter. The shape of the flowers is pretty compact, and as you can see, the sepals and petals are thinner than the lip. Now, the lip is the main attraction of the flower. It has a beautiful pattern of purple on a white background, while the sepals and petals don't really show off that much color. When they first open, they tend to be a little bit more purple, but as the time passes, they become a sort of green. They still maintain some purple dots, but it's really nothing very, very flashy. However, this whole display is just really, really pretty, and the lip, which is much broader than the sepals and petals, makes everything worth it. Now, this is not a very tiny orchid, but it is compact as long as you stabilize the pseudobulbs or pin them together with a wire, because if you let it loose, it's gonna grow in all directions. It does have the tendency to grow at pretty weird angles and take up more space than it actually needs. The foliage is not big or broad in any way, so as long as you maintain this orchid tidy, it will not take a lot of space in your growing shelf. It is also not a short orchid, but not particularly tall either. So overall, you can easily make a compact display with this orchid as long as you maintain the pseudobulbs in check. Now, you might expect the flowers to be fragrant, considering how she looks like. Well, they're not very, very fragrant, but they do possess a sort of a scent. I cannot say it's a very pleasant scent. It's not perfumey or floral or sweet. It's really hard to describe. If I were to compare it with something, maybe some medicinal cream. Stings the nose a little bit, so I don't find it particularly beautiful. But the good news is it's not very powerful. You will feel it only if you stick your nose into the flower. If you enjoy the smell, because it's not really repulsive, then that can be a bonus. But don't expect much fragrance from this orchid. It was never advertised as a fragrant orchid, actually. So pretty much the main attraction of this orchid are the blooms. And the bloom display is pretty nice, I have to say. It is far more attractive in person than I see it looks like in the camera, but sometimes the flowers tend to lose themselves in the foliage, being that they do have a pretty green color on the sepals and petals. They're not very, very visible. However, the lip is really striking. Now, the best thing about this orchid is its ease of care. It takes the exact same care as any other type of Calea type orchid. I also find it very vigorous. It didn't suffer all that much through all of the hassle with transport last year and with the lack of medium. I was not in a hurry to repot this orchid, so she spent 3 weeks without any type of medium or proper watering, and she actually was not set back. She created bigger and bigger growths no matter what, so I find it extremely, extremely hardy. I would go as far as to say she is very suited for beginners, but she does require quite a lot of light, Calea type light. Also, she is pretty drought tolerant. I would not keep this orchid constantly wet or too wet all the time. She does prefer warmer temperatures, but I've never ever had an issue with her in lower temperatures either. During winter time, it tends not to do a lot of things, but growth is decelerated quite a lot, so I don't believe this orchid will do particularly well in cooler environments, but if they're warm to even hot, I think she will do just spectacular. I don't think she can pose any type of issues, really. So from this point of view, definitely I think she will go in the top hybrids, let's say for beginners. I think you really need to try a lot to kill this orchid. So other than that, she's just a very, very pretty orchid. Sally doesn't stand out color-wise or fragrance-wise, but if you are a fan of Cattleya type orchids and these type of wild flowers, let's call them, definitely she's very charming. I do like it a lot. I do have another growth point in the back, so I can imagine multiple flower spikes will look absolutely fantastic. There seem to be a lot of varieties of the Gyrac Kiss something something. They're all a little bit different. I chose the one with the stripiest lip, as you can see, but there are a few that have a full purple lip or white and purple in a gradient effect. Some of them have more veining, mine tends to be a little spotted, so there is quite a little bit of variety. This orchid was not expensive in any way, and if you like it and decide to purchase it, I think you will not have any trouble. If you are able to grow Cattleyas, you should not have any issues with this one as well, so I would definitely say go for it. So alrighty guys, this was the beautiful Kyrtera that we've been waiting for the past 6 months, and finally she bloomed. That's my only beef with her, but she was forming the flower spike when it was pretty cool in my environment, so her metabolism was already very slowed down. I cannot blame her too much, but yeah, she seems to be the type that develops flower spikes pretty slow. You need to have patience. Other than that, she was really always just a joy to grow in all of these years, and I'm happy to finally see the pretty flower display. So alrighty guys, thank you so much for watching this video, hope you've enjoyed it. If you liked it, give this video a thumbs up. If you hated it, give it a thumbs down. And don't forget to turn on notifications so you never miss a video. And with that said, I'll see you all next time. Bye!